Well, Mr. Chairman, first of all, thank you very much for your heartfelt and kind words. And in particular, thank you for your personal travel to the East Asian Pacific region. That really makes a big difference, not only to your understanding and the Congress's understanding of the issues, but to our folks. So we thank you for that. Thank you also for your comments about the men and women who staff our embassies in the East Asia and Pacific region. We're in the people business. And as a bureau, we've made it a point of pride to seek out and attract and to develop the best people in the Foreign Service community. We have, throughout the lifespan of this administration, consistently sought to fund the rebalance. We have sought and prioritized funding, and our foreign assistance budget, as Mr. Stivers mentioned, is up about 12%. Our overall budget compared to FY15 is up about 11%. We've also deepened our collaboration and coordination with partners, industrialized nations in the region in particular, such as Japan, the Republic of Korea, Australia, and outside the region like the EU, in order to try to leverage our collaborative efforts to promote our agendas. It's quite true that other regions may have more trouble, more crises, and more countries, and that accounts for some of the disparity between the region. But like you, I'd argue that we have by far and away the best people.